Oh.
It was with what's his name? Little Dicky.
Are you serious?
Yeah, Lil Dicky, like, need a new name. And then there was a black guy with him. I don't know the black guy.
It's Gata from
Yeah, Gata. And he's like, Gata's like, what if we just name it PC Game Pass? And the like, it was obviously like really, like making fun of it. He's like,
Yeah.
oh yeah, that's a great name. And Lil Dicky's like, really? Just like that? We're already
Yeah,
done?
it's
Okay.
Gata. I wanted to make sure. Oh, you ready to do this?
I'm ready to go. I'm gonna look up the Microsoft, more of the Microsoft buying. If you wanna talk about that, if you have some topics as well.
I'm ready to go whenever I got my music ready. I've got a.
Start it up, and then you bring the first topic on. See what we wanna talk about.
I'll go ahead and share my screen. We're recording in 3, 2, 1. Welcome back to the JK podcast, where me and my buddy Jake talk about whatever the hell we want, and you know, no topics are off bounds. How we doing today, Jake?
Good. I know I asked you for a topic, but I just back to the conversation we were having 2 seconds ago.
Oh yeah.
I didn't know Candy Crush was owned by Activision Blizzard.
You didn't know that Candy Crush was owned by Activision?
No.
I think they bought it. What's the company called?
It's
King?
Activision Blizzard and King all mixed in one. I didn't know that.
Yeah, I think they bought them out in like what 20? God, it was like it had to be early in King's career. Let me
I
look
don't
that
know.
up.
You bring.
King.
What were you gonna say? Sorry, I just.
Oh, I was gonna bring up kind of a disgusting topic if you don't mind.
Hells yes.
Um.
Piss kink. Oh,
Oh.
what?
Oh, I was gonna ask you ever wipe but it never feels clean enough? You
Dude, you ever wipe and it's 30 minutes later and you're still wiping shit out of your ass? Oh my god.
I've had times, oh, I've had some terrible fucking moments when it comes to that shit. Like, I'll be on the toilet for like 15-20 minutes sometimes just wiping my fucking ass, and I don't understand why some of that residue just sticks. And it's like, dude, this is like the 20th piece of fucking toilet paper I'm fucking using, just clean.
You flush 3 times so it doesn't clog. You're
Oh
like,
yeah,
come
I think that's just a general human moment.
on. You know what I've learned to do?
Huh.
Go to the shower, put the head on jet, spread your ass cheeks,
Nah,
and then it cleans. Dude, it cleans it. It's like a bidet.
there's a better. Just buy a fucking bidet.
They're way more. They're very expensive. I have a shower at home. I actually want to.
No, actually, bidets are relatively inexpensive.
How do you spell boudin?
Bidet, BIDET, I think. It's French.
BIDET.
Yeah. And King was bought out by Activision Blizzard in 2016 for
Is that 100?
$5.9 billion.
100 and what?
5.9 billion dollars.
Oh, 5.9. That's nothing compared to the. Hold on, where is it? $68.7 billion that was just put on the table, which we'll get to later. We're not gonna bring it up now.
Yeah, let's save that a little bit. Oh, you know what I've been doing the past few days?
What's up?
I've been re-listening to old YouTube videos, and they have not aged well.
We talked about this a little bit on recording of Control.
Yeah,
But
I was watching
no.
Nanners, and I'm like, oh my God, YouTube used to be a different place.
There's a video out there. I was just watching old Unisonus videos because there's an archive for it.
Right.
And fucking, they're looking at dead YouTube channels. And one of the videos that was on there was just a girl with her tits out. Like 100% her tits out. They're like, oh, we can't have that. And they got rid of it. Like, God, YouTube was such a different time back
It
then.
used to be, man. Like, there was titties in the thumbnail. You know, if you got that, then you could do it. All it took was I mean, today the red circle with an arrow pointing at it is still like a very commonly discussed thing because it's true. That's how you get views on YouTube because they know. I don't know what it is.
It's also, what's it called? Can't have regular bleeps now.
Oh.
Like, you can't do the beep to do a cuss word.
See,
Because
I know how I'll
people.
get around it.
dolphin noises?
Oh, no. We just reverse the word.
Oh, true.
Yeah, so, like, each time, it's just a random hum. Yep. I've got my video streaming if you want to hear the music, too.
I have it. I'm watching.
Yeah.
Okay. Anything else you'd like to talk about? Because this happened 2 hours ago, by the way.
Oh, the deal that got struck?
Yeah.
Wow, and somebody already made a fucking video over it. Jesus Christ, people ride that company's dick.
They have alerts. They have inside scoops. Honestly, they probably had the video for a while because they've heard about it.
Right.
It waiting to upload until the deal was struck.
All right, should we at least talk about this a little bit?
You want to talk about it now?
Yeah, might as well.
All right, so I'll bring it. I just got added in a Discord server. That said, Microsoft is going to be buying today. This was today, a couple hours. The most I've gotten is 3 hours at most.
Okay, if this was from a Discord server, now I've got to actually look it up.
No, I'm looking it up. I'm straight looking it up. If you go to Twitter, Activision did say on their Twitter account, their official Twitter, 1 hour ago, we are joining the Xbox family.
Breaking news, Microsoft to buy the video game market. Yeah, okay. Even the New York Times is covering stuff like this.
Yeah.
Alright.
So, Xbox, Microsoft just bought out Activision, Blizzard, and King. For, you know, roughly $70 billion. Their biggest buy ever.
See, now I'm curious about the servers, though.
Well, here's the
thing. Oh, shit.
Call of
Duty.
Hold
up. Okay, keep going.
Call of Duty will finally get an anti-cheat. It will.
Overwatch
will finally get an anti-cheat.
Yeah, but Microsoft's not really had a huge success with their anti-cheats before.
Activision's.
True, it filters out a lot of the shit, but like, man, dude, I've definitely seen some issues.
I mean, you have to think, Halo, there hasn't been many hackers in Halo.
You obviously haven't been playing in the fucking lobbies I have, because I've seen people flying in Halo.
I've played commons and ranked.
I've been playing,
seen much of anything.
Big team battles are where everybody goes to fucking hack and do whatever they want, because, man, dude, I find people flying, I find people, like, shooting me in the foot, and I'm dying one shot. Like, it makes zero fucking sense how silly fucking people get around that shit. And that's not to shit on the game, because I love Halo Infinite, to be honest with you. It's the shooter I probably play the most out of all the new ones.
The one I play is probably Valorant or Overwatch, because I got back into just a little bit. it's not a bad game.
No, Valorant's actually really fun if you can play well.
Yeah.
I suck at the CSGO type shooters. I understand the mechanic of having to drag your mouse with the shape of the shooting pattern. Sorry, excuse me. Had to think of the word there. but like, I don't know. There's just like a part that doesn't make as much sense to me.
Yeah. Something we should talk about. Back to the whole Blizzard thing. That will be hearing this, hopefully this one gets a little bit more, because I think we should title it Microsoft Buys, so we get some people in here.
Yeah, I'll probably upload that, I don't know when, to be honest.
Overwatch? We already said Overwatch and Call of Duty. Anything from Raven and Treyarch will now be under oath of Microsoft.
See, and this is where...
It doesn't count the first couple Black Ops games, right? Because those are...
Those are Activision.
Are they Activision?
Yes. Whenever you load up the game, it straight up says Activision. Excuse me. But what I was curious about was how this is going to work on, like, a beta-type platform. I wonder if Xbox is going to make it to where, like... fucking Warzone's not a huge fucking massive file on your computer anymore.
Probably. They're probably going to lower file the or they're going to compress files
Well,
because
I mean, that was the biggest problem with Warzone was that its file size was too big and it required so much VRAM that it fucking ate your PC.
well, here's the thing. It Blizzard and Activision, I don't think came out fully to set it, but someone like hacked into their stuff and then found emails and shit saying they did it on purpose so other company or other games had to be uninstalled so that people would play Warzone more.
I mean, yeah, that makes so much more sense because that's how companies reel you in. But at the same time, it's such a shitty thing to do to people's
Yeah.
PCs.
I would say it also made people not want to play it because they want to play so many other games.
It's like you've got so many options on PC and you're trying to limit it down to one. I'm sorry,
Yeah.
that's not how that works.
I will say battle passes are gonna be weird now. I don't know much about Halo's battle pass. I don't know how well they did on it,
They might
but
just
like,
tie it in with Xbox, to be honest with you.
maybe, I don't know.
With the Game Pass.
You guys are gonna have to see Diablo games. I'm actually gonna pull up Battle.net on my computer right now, and I'm gonna go through a list of games that we might be having to worry about a little bit between
Oh,
guys.
Destiny for sure. For
Destiny's gonna
sure.
get a. I'm gonna bet they're gonna get a rework.
Oh,
Best first Destiny game.
if we get a reboot of the first Destiny game, I'll for sure play that on the channel because the first one was so much fun. I didn't even
All
get to
right.
play a lot of two, though.
Okay, I'm actually worried. I don't play the game personally. I'm worried about a single game.
Which one?
I don't know what's gonna happen to World of Warcraft.
Oh, I mean, it's
It's
infinite.
still not dead.
Well, yeah, no, because old school World of Warcraft got uploaded and people are complaining about how fucking glitchy it is. But no, that's just how the game was back in
I know.
the
Also, we have to think. Call of Duty Modern Warfare 2 is getting a campaign remaster currently. It's already been said that that game will still come out released on time. They don't want to ruin it. But all of these games, like,
See, I think the game that I really want a remaster for is like some of the old classics. Like, you know how we're getting the Final Fantasy VII remake, and I'm probably not gonna buy the next one for quite some fucking time. But I wouldn't mind like a full like Diablo rework, a full I think StarCraft is one of the games in the series, right? Or not in the
yeah,
series.
StarCraft is in.
Is Blizzard, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Also, I did find out only Black Ops 4 is the only one with Activision.
Are you serious?
Yeah,
When did
that's why the first three Black Ops on Steam.
I
And then,
swear to God.
no, because hold on.
Black Ops 1 developer.
I have them installed.
It is.
Yeah, Treyarch.
Wow, I got.
They're published by Activision, but they're based off Treyarch. The developer was Treyarch, and then Treyarch didn't sign with the new Activision.
That makes sense.
It was, yeah.
Now that's why I remember there being the Activision logo in those games. It's because they were just published by them.
Let's say Treyarch is the
I'm sure when I'm
that
sure.
weird like triple helix or not triple helix like
Yeah,
triple yeah.
I'm pretty sure. Is Treyarch even still a company?
Yeah.
Because I swore I heard that they dissolved.
I don't know, maybe.
Treyarch still around 2022? Did
Yeah,
Activision
Treyarch
buy.
Studios, it says on Twitter, as we look ahead into 2022,
They're
we have
just.
some thoughts.
So they're literally, just like a subsector of Activision now.
Are they? Yeah.
Yeah, they got bought out in 2001.
By Activision?
Yep.
That's weird though, because why isn't the Black Ops games on Blizzard then?
Don't know then. To be honest, it doesn't make sense honestly, but I think it's probably it has to do with copyright.
Probably fan too.
Yeah, that too.
Like, how many fans would get pissed that.
I don't know. I mean, I kind of fell out of the Call of Duty genre for a long time, and that's just because.
Three is my last good game. in my opinion.
Black Ops 3 was not anywhere as good as 2.
Story-wise, no. I'm talking about zombies, man.
Even that, I didn't like.
It's
they changed.
Two games.
I'd rather just play them on 2.
Yeah, I feel like the zombies, not they were hard in Black Ops 2, is you didn't have a lot of the movement.
See, I mean, I also grew up playing, like, World at War, Black Ops 1, and Black Ops 2, where it's, like, it's literally just fucking zombies, it's sauerkrauts, monkeys, maybe, if you're feeling frisky, and dogs. Now they got fucking aliens and flying shit at me, and it's like, there's so much shit that fucking is coming at me, I don't want... That's how I felt with 3, is like, so much is fucking happening on my screen right now, I don't know what the fuck is going on.
They had to change it up a little bit.
I get it, but it was like that... Sorry, keep going.
You go.
I mean, that, and my point with that is, like, it was like that for how long? Because it was all of World at War, it was all of, the Black Ops games besides 3.
Well, 2 started Magic.
Yeah, but it was very light. It was very, very light, and that was only if you went for Easter eggs.
I'd say, like, dragons and stuff were a big thing in 2. The one, like,
in all 2,
the maps had magical everything.
In 2 or in 3?
2. Because 2 was buried, and 2 did, what's it called? I can't think of the fucking name.
For the DLC, maybe, yeah. Cause like,
no, what's the name? Origins.
Yeah, Origins definitely had magic, but that was a part of the Easter egg though, and I if you didn't go for that, it was just zombies.
In general.
Right, but I mean, like, I don't know, man. There was just something that flipped, and I stopped paying attention after that point.
That's why I like 3 as an end. Now I will say, and I think you've played it, the new Black Ops Cold War zombies felt a lot like the original.
Yeah, it did. It brought back those old roots. It brought back the mystery of it all and how it all worked. And it wasn't like all in your face and fucking stupid like how a lot of that was going.
And it was difficult.
Yeah, it was a relatively good challenge.
It's still difficult to this day. Like, I'm still trying to get some of the camos for zombies.
I don't know, man. I fell out of zombies once it hit 3.
Like I said, 3 is my final draw, and then skip all the way up to Cold War.
I just feel like they took the original concept of zombies, and they just started adding shit that wasn't zombies.
By the way, I don't think I can hear the music.
You sure?
Out of the stream.
Oh, it's because I'm doing that. My bad. Hang on. Let me get you that for you.
I will say, okay, so there's a couple games that I currently have.
Can you hear it now?
No.
No?
No.
What the fuck? You can't hear that at all. Alright, I'm done. I'm done doing it. We're done there. This has been a reoccurring issue the entire time that we've been doing stuff. I do not understand.
No. It's been a reoccurring issue since apparently the last, like, 10 episodes of Dragon Quest.
And we have no fucking clue why. Because, like, it was working at the beginning of Dragon Quest. It was working halfway
through.
All through Mother, and now it just doesn't want to fucking play the computer audio on his ear, and it doesn't make any sense. But fuck me, man.
So we have to finish Control pretty fast.
I figured that it's coming up to the end here soon. It has to be.
Well, here's the thing. I want to finish Control and Five Nights fast because there's some games coming out that I want to try to get ahead of the curve on.
I mean, yeah. What you got?
That Elden Ring game I was talking to you about? In 5 weeks, we have 5 weeks, so in February 24th, we have a while.
Right, but you also aren't figuring in that I need recording sessions too.
I know.
It's going to be rough.
This weekend, I can do Sunday. Let's talk about this not podcast.
Yeah.
But on the podcast, well, I want to play Elden Rings, mm-hmm. and I want to play that inscription game that I was talking to you about.
Right, you were talking to me about a little bit about those.
And I don't want you to look up too much on it, because I've seen a little bit. So,
I've seen nothing. I haven't looked anything up. Just what you've told me.
We have to get a couple more episodes of Dragon Quest out.
Right, right. And then I think I've got myself the next series planned, and then the series after that, too.
Yeah, Elden Rings is a Dark Souls-type game. So, it's gonna be a while. Like, the series is gonna be longer. But I think it'll be, like, a fill-in.
Oh, kind of like the, like a, we don't know what else to put in here.
Yeah, so, like, say we're doing a series, say, like, I'm doing a series, yeah, with Inscription. Say, like, there's been, like, a lot of Inscription in a row.
Right.
I'll pop in an Elden Ring in there.
Right.
So they can, what, see us suffer.
See, usually when it comes to that, I'd usually alternate, but you saw what happened last time we did that. We overworked the hell out of ourselves.
Yeah, that's why I say we should probably just focus on one.
Yeah, that's why I'm doing Dragon Quest just for a little while. Which, I guess now I can talk about the crazy shit that happened with that series.
Yeah, buddy.
So, okay. Let's date this. Today is January 18th, 2022.
Yep, and will not go up on this date.
No,
it will not.
It more than likely. So for a long time there, we were just posting like Mother, Control, and I think there was one more in the mix there that we were doing at the time.
We did FNAF, and we did a little bit of Cuphead.
Yeah, yeah. So for that time, all the way up to about when Halloween happened. So October 20th, I can't remember, 31st, when's Halloween? When the fuck is Halloween?
31st.
Okay, yeah. So from then, when we started doing the Back for Blood episodes, which, thank God, that's over.
Next Halloween, bubby!
We got some time before we do some more scary stuff. But all the way before that, there was a recording of mine from October 7th. It's just...
Do I know this story?
It's the Dragon Quest. Seems
the
like...
one you forgot?
Yeah, I forgot like a straight-up hour of content existed.
Did you skip the episode?
No, I didn't skip the episode. We ended at 20... I think it's 22 is where we ended up off at. So when that episode came out, I just completely forgot that recording session even existed. I just was like, we need to finish Mother, damn it.
Well, yeah, because we I don't know why we picked such long series.
Well, Mother wasn't entirely long.
No, but we had a lot of things in between it.
Yeah, we had like,
we had
Cuphead,
Craft, we had Cophead, we had Back for Blood, we had Control. We had Dragon Quest and Mother at the same
time. Yes, I mean, obviously, like, and on top of that, trying to keep up with the podcast and thing like that, which we both, let's admit it, we both blew it off for quite some time.
Yes, but I think we did it because this isn't always the main focus of our channel.
No, this is mostly just for fun and talking and, yeah, you know, getting our ideas out there into the ether.
And we also took, like, a week off Christmas.
Yeah, so we could go be with family and just relax, which is something me and you never really do.
No. Not really. Not anymore.
Which, I mean, obviously, yeah, we're gonna take it one step at a time, obviously, and, you know, figure out more times that we can take vacations. Probably a summer vacation type plan, just so we can, you know, go do some stuff with family, you know, relax. Figure stuff like that out, but
we might have a schedule, like scheduled recordings.
Yeah. Which I mean, did we ever talk about the new recording schedule, or not the new recording schedule, the upload schedule?
Monday, Tuesday, Thursday, Friday.
Yeah. So I mean, we kind of came to a big decision that like 5 days a week is hard.
Yeah, and it's impractical for two of us because one of us would have to do 3 days and
Yeah.
like we're gonna do four.
And it Monday, Tuesdays is when Jake's gonna be uploading his end of the editing, and Thursday, Fridays is usually when I'm gonna be uploading mine. Obviously, there's gonna be some work around with that in case, like, oh, we didn't get an edit done in time, or, like.
Me and him have backups for each other, is what
Yeah.
he's trying to say.
Basically, like, it's okay to move around the video a little bit in case of emergency, but for the most part, we're trying to keep it to Monday, Tuesday, Thursday, Friday. On uploads.
Remember, we still both work real jobs
Yeah.
as well, so there is still a little leeway.
Speaking
Like,
of which.
speaking of which, I got off work and started this. Like, I'm a little
Oh,
tired, if
fuck,
you couldn't
really?
tell. Oh, yeah, I work. I
Damn,
got
buddy,
off
I didn't
at
know that. I'm
seven.
sorry, dude.
Oh, no, you're fine. Like, that's just how it is. I work thirds. It's not a good time in the weekday for me unless it's like 2 o'clock in the afternoon, but then you're
Right.
getting ready for work.
Right, because I go into work at 5 and, I need to shower, eat food, and be a fucking person.
But the best way is for me to stay up just like an extra hour or two, which I don't mind. It really doesn't bother me.
Right, I mean, obviously, I don't want to push you, though, because.
Oh yeah, I get you. And
Yeah.
I want to get back into streaming more, which I am going to with a friend,
Yeah.
with the Nuzlocke and stuff. But then I have some solo stuff I want to do, and then me and Kyle have some ideas, which we're gonna be pushing ahead here soon,
I don't want to
hopefully.
talk about too much on what I have planned for the recording docket, just because I want to leave at least some mystery to it. Obviously, like, we can talk about certain games and stuff like that we want to play, but I don't want to give, like, a for sure, like, this is happening here and now. Because, like, how do I put this? I want to leave at least some kind of surprise.
So some suspense.
Yeah, because, like, I've told you a few games in my that I have in mind for the next upcoming series, but I think we finally came to a decision when I was talking about to you about the randomizers. I'll say that much. I think I came to a decision on what the next series is gonna be just by talking about it a little bit.
Hold on. Sorry, I got the things finished encoding.
Oh yeah.
File
Go
encoder
through.
detected.
I would go through
Yeah.
and make sure that it,
It said it in the notepad, a file importer detected an inconsistency in the file structure.
What did
Could not
you.
write the XMP data in output file queue stopped.
What the fuck? I've never seen that. You might have to look up that code.
We'll do that later.
Yeah.
Speaking of which, there might be a weird episode today with
Oh, yeah.
Ben.
We've
I'll
been
fix
having
it.
some weird coding issues when it comes to YouTube and
You have audio
Premiere.
issues. I have uploading issues. And
I do not know why we have so many fucking issues when it comes to recordings because
we didn't at all until recently.
we don't change anything though. That's the thing. Like, whenever we upload something, it is consistently we keep the settings as close as possible. Unless OBS updates or window update. In that case, then we have to go back through and change everything.
Yep, I'm gonna have to hopefully re-edit. I hope it's something not like in the video, because if that file got erased, there's nothing we can do.
Yeah, I mean, there's not really like a file system, so.
I don't know. I'll figure it out. Back to the podcast. Sorry, I didn't
Yeah.
mean to.
No, like, I mean, this is still part of the whole thing, but like. It's okay to rant when we talk about this stuff on the podcast, 'cause it happens, man. This is just like the daily fucking life of recording.
If you guys have any first tips or tricks on editing and
Right,
stuff,
right.
please let us know.
I mean, I'm always
And
open to learning new shit about software, 'cause then I'm like, ooh, piece of candy.
And also, if you have any games specifically you guys want to see that we might be interested in, because me and Kyle both love roguelikes,
Yeah, I mean, I
like
don't.
all that type.
I won't promise anything,
No,
obviously.
just ideas.
But, like, if you're interested in a series and stuff like that, and, might just leave a comment, and maybe we'll get to it, maybe we won't. It just depends on what we're doing at the time, because obviously I've got my own, choices, let's say.
I totally understand. Like, we still gonna do what we wanna do, like, for a while. But if they have some, like, things that we might be interested in. Might as well check it out.
Right. I'm just showing. there's a secret JoJo now in this video.
Great.
But like, yeah, for at least a little bit, I've got a few games planned out. Some I'm not entirely sure I'm gonna enjoy, but others I know are gonna be super fun.
Yeah.
Like, I can't, it probably won't be for a little bit, but I can't wait for Chrono Trigger.
Yeah, that one's gonna be a lot. That one. Playing Chrono Trigger, right? Are you
playing? I'm playing Chrono Trigger, just
which
because.
Which is the one I'm playing?
Earthbound.
Not that one, the other one.
Oh,
this is the power of the Monada.
Oh, Xenoblade.
Yeah, I'm playing Xenoblade.
Just because, I've already seen the game, and there's no way I'm gonna have a first-time experience like that ever again. And to capture...
You are playing 2, though.
I will play 2.
Yeah.
Yeah. Just because, even though I've seen the game, I've not seen all of it, to be honest with you. And, I mean, there's a DLC second game that's, like, at least a good... I can't remember how many hours the second game is, but it's... If you're doing everything, which you have to complete the game... it's gonna take a while. It's gonna take a long time to get through that series.
We're gonna stick to a couple shorter ones for a little bit.
Yeah!
We've found out that Dragon Quest...
Shorter!
Dragon Quest is no joke. When we thought it was gonna be like...
I've seen
hours wise what was gonna be, but I guess we didn't put it in perspective until we started recording it.
Yeah, because like, especially with dying at certain areas, because like, that the Let's Plays that I've been seeing were like minimal death, like very very minimal recordings that had death in it, and that's where I started getting scared when I started seeing 150 episodes. I'm like, I don't know if I've got that much commitment. I kind of want to play it.
First dropped series.
Well, it won't be dropped. It's just gonna be either moved to the stream, or and we'll just post the VODs of it, or it'll be one of those, you know, in between series where like, if I can't think of what I want to play next, I'll just play some Dragon Quest.
Yeah. Oh, you don't mind if I upload the Nuzlocke.
No, I don't care.
Do you?
Okay. No. Create a folder called VODs, though, if you would.
Okay, just. I'll make... Yeah.
And then date it, obviously. But other than that, no, I don't give a damn.
You mean playlist?
Yeah. Make a playlist that's called VODs, and then date it. So date when the VOD was done and all that, and yada yada, just so that it's
okay. Yeah,
consistent. But no, I don't care. Obviously.
Alrighty, sounds good. I think that'll bring in some people. The Pokemon community.
And then I have no idea when we're gonna do it, but I still have yet to get through all of Yakuza 0.
The Yakuza's got taken off Xbox.
I know they did, but I still own it on Steam.
Well, I know. I thought that was sad, because I wanted to play through on my own. Sometime. After we were done recording it.
Oh, dude, that's definitely one of those series that we're never going to be able to take seriously.
Oh, yeah, because that's all the dancing stuff.
But you haven't even seen, like, the best ones, though. You've only seen 24 Hour Cinderella, probably.
Yeah. Wait, we get you, huh?
Dame.
you gotta play through Alien Isolation sometime.
I don't know, man. That game, I played a little bit with you back at the house at one point, and I was just like, man, this is not my type of fucking game, man.
Man, this is creepy.
I'm like, dude, I don't like creepy shit. Right, I mean, it's not nearly as bad, but I'm like, dude, this is definitely like some nightmare shit, the shit that I see. Like, Jesus. Oh, no, you're good. I was just gonna say, because I have some pretty fucked up nightmares from time to time.
We're also still waiting on grounded stuff.
Right. I mean, I want the game to fully come out before we come make a comeback to that, though.
I'm gonna look up and see if there's any like news on them.
From what I've seen, they're doing pretty well. Like I think we're still I think it's still the Shroom and Gloom update or something, or whatever the hell they called it.
Yeah, Shroom and Gloom.
Nah, but like I don't know. It's been an interesting few weeks.
Yeah.
Yeah. Work's definitely been a fun topic. Let's put it at that. Yeah.
Yeah, sounds fun.
To put it lightly, corporate company being a dickhead and fucking me over. I'm just getting sick of it.
I gotcha.
Yeah. I don't want to put too much work insight into that because obviously I'm still under an NDA for certain
Yeah.
topics. Which I didn't know until I joined the job that apparently I signed an NDA when I was in the
You didn't read what you were signing?
Nope. I thought it was just like a normal, W-2, get your paperwork done. Nope, that had a full NDA attached to it, and I'm like, oh, cool. I can't talk about the company too much.
Yeah.
I can talk about the company, I just can't name the company or like anything like that. It's definitely a pain, but like, the more that I'm here, the more that I'm like, I might be leaving soon.
I mean, well, we'll see what happens and keep you guys updated.
Yeah, 'cause I've got some plans ahead of me for what I want to do. Oh, I got my did I tell you that for all of the time that we've been recording, I haven't had earmuffs on my ear head or my earphones?
Yeah, you've mentioned that before.
And how I was just bare earing that shit the whole time.
Probably why you can't last more than a couple hours.
Yeah, I mean honestly, that shit hurts after a bit because now I actually have some muffle to it.
Oh yeah. Ugh.
Plus it's nice and cushy and these are so they smell good too.
Yeah.
Like now that I'm wearing them I can smell them. Let's make
Any other
sure.
topics you want to bring up?
I mean we've got only 30 minutes here, so like yeah, I've got some we got plenty of time.
Alrighty, anything you want to bring up? You mind if I take a go grab a drink real fast?
Yeah, we'll go ahead and pause real quick.
Alright, cool.
And we're back. All right.
Anything else you want to bring up?
I've got really. I mean, I've got a few things, honestly, but like, yeah, I don't know. Talking about that on the podcast might be a little taboo, if you will.
I mean, probably.
It's hard to talk about like dirty shit when you're listening to jazz music.
Hey, why not? Talk about it.
All right, fine. So I came across a porno the other day
Alrighty. I love where this is going.
I was very confused because you know that I find all those weird ones, right?
Oh,
Like
yeah, of course. I found a couple goodies.
pterodactyl porn and shit like that. If you haven't seen that,
Lemon Tree, yeah.
Lemon Tree. Well, I came across one the other day, and I swear to God, one of the lights was purposely made this way, and it was like, oh man, I gotta remember how the line went. It was like, oh, you like that, baby? You like that? And she's like, yeah, stick it up my ass, stick it up my ass, and she's like, ass, just very screechy about it.
That's great.
That wasn't the weird part, though. The weird part was that another chick came in, and somehow, I don't know why, that I watched this woman's clitoris grow into a dick.
Nice.
I'm so confused to this day as to what I saw.
Dude, I ain't even gonna lie to you. Here, here, ready for this? Ready for this? I just went to Pornhub, right? For
mm-hmm. a second.
Because there's some great titles.
Oh, dude, the title.
Like, the free ones have the titles. And here's the one that just popped up. You better stop doing that. You're gonna end up with my dick.
Dick in your ass? I saw that one too.
Jesus Christ.
That's a step sibling one.
People get hard at nudist camps? Question mark. My stepmom would be pissed if she found out you're putting your dick in me. What the hell?
Oh, where's another good one? Oh my God, I'm gonna come. Rough sex makes no, that's not really funny.
hold on. Here's a good one. I'm thankful for my stepmom's titties. They are so helpful when I'm fantasizing.
Okay, so you're under the step sibling tab then.
No, this is best of 2021.
Oh my God. I mean, at least they have a sense of humor though.
Oh yeah.
Like, if you were in the porn industry, you have to have a huge sense of humor to be able to make it, because Jesus Christ, that's the only way anybody's actually gonna watch your videos.
Have you seen that video of the cameraman feeding the guy? that was fucking the girl. In the middle of it. He was fucking her, and the guy's eating like a donut or a piece of pizza, and he nudges over to the dude that was fucking her, and he's like, shrugs, and he starts feeding her while he's still fucking her, and the woman just stops and goes, what are you doing?
You know that's an actual job, right?
Yeah.
Being the caterer for porn industries. Do you know how fun that has to be?
Dude, I'm gonna have to find that video.
There's gotta be someone in the industry who would be willing to talk to us about that, because that would be the funniest goddamn job ever. I'd be making dick and pussy jokes all day long.
Dude, could you imagine doing an interview with a fucking...
Johnny Sins.
Oh my God. He's famous in a heartbeat.
Getting one interview with, like, Johnny Sins or something stupid like that would be the big highlight of my career.
Dude.
Oh.
He'd be set for life.
Get, like, election... Like, honestly, we just start bringing on, like, people from pornos and interview.
Why not, right?
Alexis Texas, shit like that. Mia Khalifa, bring her into the mix. Because apparently,
she
hates it, but like, honest to God, I think it's made her more humorous as a person.
Oh yeah,
because
she hates everything she's done. Do you know the best? Apparently, she's like the queen of anal. Give me a second. I could probably look that up.
From what I heard, she doesn't do anal.
No, not Mia. Not Mia.
Oh.
An A. Edarina,
Chekhov? I don't know.
Adriana, Chechik.
Don't people get hard at nudist camps?
She went on an interview recently, right?
Hmm.
And she said that she has horrible back problems to the point of, she needs... realigned spine.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, dude, no. Like, from doing just, like sex. There's, like, different
what
positions.
What the fuck?
Yeah, no, she has, like, a horribly disformed back. A couple of the... What's it called?
Jesus Christ, she's throwing that shit back.
What are they called? The little plates across the spine?
Oh, vertebrae.
Yeah, she has vertebrae that are out of place. Like... She's fucked up.
Oh fuck, man. That's sad, dude. Like, she's literally given everything to the porn industry.
Yeah, 110%.
That's a fucked up situation. I mean, but like, then you have to think about all the washed up ones that have gone through it and are just, you know, they're now mothers, and fucking now they're just done with the industry.
I mean, 100% true.
How do you face yourself after that in the mirror? Like, you're a mom now, you got a kid who probably has seen you in pornos.
Well, that's like the worst part, right?
Like how do you hide it?
Your kid watch your own porn.
Right, how do you hide it, right?
You don't. There's nothing.
It's like once you've done it, there's nothing you can do. That shit is out there, and one day your kid's gonna watch him getting it, like his him getting fucking made.
He will never watch porn again.
Oh no, that'll be the end of it. I mean, it's like people who watch Corey Chase or fucking, like, who are just chasing after basically their moms. It's like Jesus.
Like, do me a favor, Kyle. Do you want to picture your mom in a porno?
Fuck no! Fuck no! Are you kidding me? God, I already have fucking nightmares from that. Ugh. Ugh. God, from the last from the Dragon Quest episode. Huh.
If you haven't checked that out, check that out.
That's that's
definitely funny.
I don't think that's even gone up yet. That's the thing. I don't think we've met Michelle the Mermaid.
You can't even say it without cringing.
Ugh. Like, that gives me nightmares, let alone finding a porn of my mom.
especially, like, if it was still, like, with your dad.
Oh, God.
Never, ever watch porn.
No, I'd be done. I'd be done. My jerking off career would be over. I wonder if there is a person out there that's kept track of how many times they've beat their dick. Total.
I did the math in school. So I don't remember exactly like the fucking equations we did.
The equations?
Dude, I ain't even gonna lie. So I do it at least probably once a day, maybe twice. And I Kat was with me while I was doing this fucking equation. I was together with Kat. We were at the lunch table trying to figure out who masturbated the most in their life.
Oh, it's probably me.
I outranked Drew.
Bro. So, I'm sorry. Even if I only did it once a day, every day, I started at 10. Like, even if I did it, like, because I definitely did not. There were definitely, like, benders where I just do that because that was what it was. That's what was fun to do during the day.
That was just something you could do.
Right, it was just something to fucking do. Of course, Ma always taught us that, you know, it's ours, so play with it if you wanna, you know? Which is the healthy response as a parent, but...
parents are like, it's a sin.
No.
Like, it's dopamine.
I mean, but at the same time, it does cause long-form depression. And
100%.
Because, like, if you're constantly hitting that fucking dopamine button over... It's like, have you seen the science experiments with rats on cocaine?
I think so.
So, basically, they had a control substance, which was just water, right? But then they mixed water and cocaine. And the way...
crazy?
Basically, they would hit this button, and it would give them this water with cocaine. And they would just keep fucking hitting it, and keep fucking hitting it, and keep fucking hitting it. But then they did the test later, and they added, like, different stuff to do, and the rats would only come up to the button every so often.
Really?
Yeah. But, I mean, going back to that first experiment, that's essentially what you're doing when you're beaten off, is you're just pressing that dopamine button over and over and over again, and it's just causing, like, massive amounts of depression in the world, because, like, your brain can't physically handle that much dopamine.
Yeah, I can't say how many times I've done it and was just like, that didn't even give me anything.
I mean, I don't think I could even put it into a number. That's the thing. I do not, even if it was once a day from when I was 10 years old till now, it still would not be correct. Because younger Kyle was a fucking deviant, man.
We have all probably masturbated at least more than 100 times.
I mean, even, because, like, I don't care how Christian you are as a person.
You've done it once.
Just, you've, because there's curiosity in that shit, man.
And I'm sorry to whoever female is dating a man. They have masturbated while dating you.
Yeah, I mean, probably to you. Yeah, more than likely, I've definitely known some guys out there who were Facebook picture, profile picture masturbators.
Oh, God, I don't like that.
Yeah, I mean, if that's where it starts getting creepy. Like, ooh, slow down there, chief. Like, I mean, don't get me wrong. Do what you want.
A little personal. Weirdest thing you've masturbated to.
Oh, for sure.
That you can say on the internet.
Ooh, oh, that's a tough one.
Which part that you can have to say on the internet?
Well, yeah, that I can say on the internet and the weirdest. It's like, oh. Because I've definitely seen strange porn, but I haven't jerked off to it, you know? Cause the Game Grumps, Gay Brothers. I watched all of that, and that didn't excite me whatsoever, cause I'm not into the.
It was the same thing with Aaron and Dan.
Yeah,
didn't actually masturbate to it.
No, we just watched it cause it was funny.
Yeah.
But I mean, after a certain point, it just turns to gay sex, and you're like, I don't want to watch this.
Yeah.
So you turn it off. But Anthony, I mean, that's a fucking classic. But, I mean, like, God, I think when I was younger, I watched some pretty fucked up stuff, like milking porn and shit like that, but I'm not a huge fan of that.
Not too bad.
No, but it's still pretty fucking weird.
Lactation isn't...
Oh, dude, it's funny you mentioned that.
Oh, God.
I saw a hentai the other day.
I love the start of that sentence.
It was one of those things where you start jerking off, and then, like, you slowly stop because the story just kind of, like, huh?
Dude, I ain't even gonna lie. I've had, the hentai that I've watched, and I'm like, I'm gonna jerk off to this. And then I've fallen in love with the story? And I'm like, no! That can't be!
Obviously they're just pictures, right? So it's not anything that's not too strange, but like... I was watching, and it was like, all of a sudden this young kid is getting with like his stepmom. And I'm like, okay, this is fucking weird, but go on, I'm interested in the plot, you've already hooked me, so go on, tell me more.
I'm already horny.
Well, no, I'm not horny at this point, because it's like, stepmom's not really a kink of mine, I guess.
Fair.
But like, I'm watching, and I'm just like, so what's going on with this kid, man? Like, why is he so upset? And then all of a sudden... She goes, oh, you need to release some tension. And I'm just like, whoa!
That was fast.
I'm like, what the fuck, man? Like, that's not how that works.
Dude.
There's like a buildup that you gotta have to that shit.
If hentai was like, if sex was as real as hentai, there'd be so much sex.
Fucking tentacles just start popping out of the fucking
No. Earth. I'm talking about the way they start sex.
Oh, dude, like.
If that was real. There'd be so much sex in the world.
I mean, yeah, because, like, they make it look so easy.
It's not that easy.
I mean, it is, but it isn't.
Girls usually have some type of weapon, no?
Well, it's not about the weapon, it's about caring enough to be around for, you know, both the good and the bad. Or if you're just an asshole, you pump and dump, and that's just how you live your life, but...
You just got incredibly worse quality in your mic.
Oh, it's because I'm moving around a little bit.
I was like...
Yeah, I fixed it.
Yes, you did.
Yeah. But like... I don't know, man. Porn has gotten so weird over the years. I mean, it's like, did you hear that Amaranth's OnlyFans nudes got leaked all over the internet? So now you can just get them for free.
I'm gonna call you right back, Don't you fucking judge me.
No, dude, like, legitimately that happened and she's pissed because, like, nobody's buying her... Like, well, I shouldn't say nobody. The simps are still buying her OnlyFans shit, but it's like...
She shouldn't be mad. She's set for the rest of her goddamn life.
Yeah, she did, like, her fucking... Ugh. I still, to this day, think that the big... Oh, God. I haven't heard that name in a fucking minute.
Well, you know what happened, right? So, Belle Delphine's nudes got leaked. And people got pissed. Because she was making a bunch of money off of it, right?
Right.
Well, what ended up happening was none of them had any sort of naked picture on it. She never posted a single naked picture.
It was just her with dildo.
It was her dildos, like, stuff, like, duct tape and stuff, blah, blah, blah. But the thing was, like... People were still buying it.
I mean, yeah, because I do not understand the whole simp thing. Because, like, I have never felt that way towards a woman that I would give up my fucking wallet for them. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like, because...
That's when simping's gone too far.
But
simping,
like,
in general, it's not a bad thing. To care for a woman isn't a bad thing. But don't let them tell you it is.
But, like... When it gets down to the point where you're spending all of your money just to support their habits and stuff like that,
even though they have enough money,
or they don't give you anything in return that's worth even that amount, I mean, that's when it becomes a problem, in my opinion. And you can do whatever the fuck you want, obviously. I'm not gonna tell you how to live your life, because, you know...
Yeah, do what you want with your money. We're not gonna judge.
But, like, me personally, I'm gonna take that fucking $500 check that you just spent on Amaranth's nudes, and go spend it on, like, fucking... I don't know, socks, shoes, fucking food. You know what?
I also bring out the point that I don't get why people spend $500,000 on a pair of shoes.
I don't know either, to be honest with you. I mean, I'm wearing fucking Levi's.
I have a singular pair of shoes. Actually, I have two pairs.
I do have a lot of pairs of shoes.
But how many of them you gotten for free, and you have paid less than $50 for?
Oh, most of the ones that might... I mean, besides, like, the ones I get from Ross's, because those usually are quality and will last me a while. But, like... I've got probably 6 or 7 pairs of shoes in that closet right now that are
exactly.
That are all free. And that's not counting the other ones. You never know when I'm going to need those. Okay? Okay, why is Happy Birthday playing? That's copyright as fuck. Yeah, that's...
I thought they uncopyrighted that song.
No, that's still a copyrighted song.
I'm gonna have to look into that.
Is Happy Birthday copyrighted? Warner Chappell Music actively enforced a copyright on the song Happy Birthday since 1949 and charged commercial users a royalty for such use as in movies, games, and public performance for profit. Like We Shall Overcome, the song is now in the public... Oh, it's in the public domain now, so it must have been added recently. I told you about the song that's now going to be probably a little homage that I have set up.
Yes, I do.
So recently a song called The Maple Leaf Rag got added to the public domain, and I'm gonna abuse the shit out of it. I'm gonna use that for everything. And just because, I mean, like, once those old songs become completely open to the public, we can just use them.
Oh, yeah.
Like,
they're funny.
Yeah, I mean, some of the old music's good, and the thing is, like, in the future, like, 20, 30 years from now, some of the songs from, like, the 70s and 80s will be open to us. So we might have access to, like, Rush and shit like that.
That'd be so funny.
Oh, dude, if I could play Rush... on stream, dude.
I'm gonna stop us.
I don't know when it. God damn it, Luna. I don't know when I'm gonna do it, but eventually I'm gonna pick up guitar again and try and relearn it.
I want to learn bass.
But I want to do like video game music and stuff like that and create like you know, stuff like that. Luna, what the hell are you doing? Sorry, she's yelling at me.
Your kitty cat.
Yeah. Whoa! Jesus Christ, you animals. I'm watching them. Sadie just jumped over like half of her, the cat tree. And then Luna pops out the hole, Tiny fucking attacks her. I'm like, Jesus, it's literally a whole zoo at my house at this point.
Are you tired of cats yet?
No, I can't be. I'm mad at Sadie, though.
What did she do?
She broke one of the big glasses. She pushed it off my desk last night, and I was working, so I couldn't clean it up, and there was just broken glass on my fucking floor for like 10 minutes.
Which, yeah, you probably weren't happy about that.
No, I fucking wasn't, because after I got off work, and I won't lie, I had a little bit to drink last night, but not enough to impair me, just enough to make me feel okay, because I was not having a good day.
That's the word you want to hear when drinking. Well, makes me feel okay.
I mean, it wasn't enough to be an issue, just enough to help me relax, yeah, because I was definitely not relaxed.
Oh, I understand.
And then when that happened, my blood pressure just fucking shot up, and I was like, God.
It sounds like you're reliving those feelings.
Oh, I go through that shit enough as is. I I'm pretty sure there's still glass shards all over my fucking floor that I missed, and it's like, I can't catch a break! But I mean, that's really, it's not the end of the world. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Things could definitely be a lot worse in terms of stuff, where I'm at personally and blah, blah, blah.
Blah, 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 blah?
Yeah, that's where I'm at emotionally. Oh, I started watching Boruto again.
Yeah, you told me, and you're mad that they got rid of all the funny pauses.
Yeah, they did. I mean, it looks better animation-wise, but man, that was like the best part about watching Naruto, is that you would pause at a random moment, at a random frame, and you'd get the fun, like, pain. The whole, like, I know that. Yeah, are you even at the pain fight yet? I don't even think
no,
so.
No.
Yeah, you're way behind.
I am currently. Sai's a good guy now.
Okay. Yeah, I know exactly where.
And Kosuke is like, all right, Naruto, we're gonna do some training, and you might be able to surpass me.
Do you mean Kakashi? Then,
what did I say?
Kakasuke.
Oh yeah. Kakashi. But yeah, he's like, they just got back from the mission of failing to save Sasuke.
So yeah, I know exactly where you are then. Yeah. But like, that the entire time with that, the entire time with like early Naruto with the Chunin exams, how Sasuke's got like certain frames where his neck is completely twisted.
Dude, I just saw one like of the main scenes with Sai, and he's completely fucked up. So funny.
Like, it's one of my favorite memes of the internet, is just Naruto being paused, because it that was my childhood. Like, we would pause the fucking episode, and we'd just laugh hysterically from, like, at least 10, 15 minutes at a time, because, like, it was just so much fun to do.
Oh, yeah.
And it's like, now so many kids can relive that with, like, Hulu and all that. It's like, back in the day, we had to wait to be able to do stuff like that. TiVo, that shit. Remember when TiVo was a fucking thing?
Yeah,
it did. Is it even still around at this point?
I don't think so.
Because, like, most cable companies now allow you to record TV shows. Like, I know,
It's
DirecTV and Dish did.
It's changed a lot since we were kids, buddy.
I haven't had cable TV in so fucking long.
It's expensive.
It is. It's not worth it. Unless you buy it in a bundle plan. But like,
yeah, no one wants to do that.
Most internet companies have gotten rid of that because nobody wants fucking cable. I don't want to watch that shit. Better shit online. That's why my computer's hooked up to my TV. I can watch anything I want, whatever the fuck I want.
Yeah.
I mean, I've also gotten, I mean, I'm rewatching Boruto. Witcher 2, or The Witcher Season 2 came out.
I haven't watched any of it yet.
I haven't either. I've been waiting on it. We should really do TV nights sometime.
Probably. That'd probably be a good idea.
Yeah, like, just sit down with, like, a group of friends. I mean, we could even, like, record it and make it a fun little thing, but, like, overall, I think I just want to watch TV with my bud.
I'm fine with that.
Yeah. I don't know what, when we should do that, but obviously, because, like, our work schedule's all fucked up and...
It'd have to be a weekend.
Yeah, it would have to be on the weekend, probably, day after we record or something, because most of the time we do it on Saturdays.
Yeah.
Unless
we can do it a lot more when, we have the studio set up. I can just come over and we can just...
Yeah, literally, it could be like, you just show up and we just start playing a fucking game and recording.
Yeah, buddy.
The only reason that's being held up is because I needed to get my car checked up.
Oh, dude, you're totally fine about that.
Yeah. After that broke down on me, I mean, that was probably...
What was going on?
Nope. Still don't know. It's running fine now.
Yeah, I think it was just too cold.
I think it literally was... I didn't have a lot of gas in it. It was too cold, and the gas ended up freezing up in the line. Like... But gasoline doesn't freeze well unless there's, like, a small amount, you know?
Yeah.
So, I don't know.
I mean, engines in normal just can't function very well. In
It's true. I mean, combustion's a thing. I'm just glad it works now, man.
Yeah.
I'd rather be, you know, be able to do what I need to do.
Of course.
Trying to think.
Is there any other like big announcements you've heard over the last couple of days?
The new Kirby game got its trailer released.
Oh yeah, I didn't even know there was a new Kirby game.
Yeah, I meant to show you that earlier, but during the last Nintendo Direct, I think it was. Let me look this up. New Kirby.
Well, Cat'll be excited about that.
Yeah. March 25th, we're getting Kirby and the Forgotten Lands.
Huh.
And the way that it looks, it's kind of like it's a 3D Kirby. So it's kind of imagine like Mario Odyssey, but Kirby.
Alrighty then.
Yeah. So, I mean, I'm interested at least. I liked, Triple Deluxe, which also played with the 3D mechanic, but not totally.
They didn't know what they were doing with it.
Right, so I mean, I should probably get off this before a porno starts blaring.
Probably a good idea.
Yeah, but like, I'm excited to see what they end up doing with it because like, I'm nervous with the direction Nintendo's taking. To be honest with you.
Yeah.
I feel like we're gonna lose our handhelds.
They're gonna get more console.
Yeah, well, they're gonna turn it more into, like, this is a console. Like, Metroid Dread was a huge, huge thing, because that was, like, one of the few 2D platformers they had on there, besides, like, you know, the SNES Classic and NES Classics.
Yeah.
But, like, since Metroid Dread's release, which I haven't even got to play yet, I'm sad about that, because I'm honestly waiting for the channel to do it.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. Because, I mean, like, it looks so fun, and it looks like something we could just have fun with. And
I agree. That's pretty good.
But I really want to learn the speed run route to it.
Do you know the speed? You know the bomb jumps in the first game, though.
I know. I used to. I say speed run, but it's really I just knew the routing, and I learned how to play the game really fast. But I used to speedrun Super Metroid back in the day. Nothing serious. And trust me, my name's not going to be on any fucking leaderboard because I was still trash at the game. People could beat that game in 30 minutes. I got to like 50, and that was like the closest I ever got to beating it quickly. But the one I really want to learn to do is the randomizer for it. Cause that looks hard as fuck.
Does it?
Yeah, cause like they have it to where you can do a Link to the Past and a Super Metroid randomizer, and it connects, and the items are interlocked, and you can.
Ew.
Oh yeah, but they have like set destination for portals that you can switch back and forth between the two games, kind of like how, you know, Link to the Past works.
Yeah.
I mean, it looks super difficult, but looks super fun.
Oh, that sounds so annoying.
I mean, I think Link to the Past has 125 checks, and Super Metroid, oh god, I can't, how many missile packs alone are there?
I don't know.
How many missile packs Super Metroid? Just in missile packs alone, that's an energy tank. That's not missile packs. There are 50 super bombs in just Super Metroid. 4 reserve tanks. 21 total missile packs. That sounds close to like 100. Again, 120 checks in that, so well over 300 fucking checks that you have to go through. But man, it looks so fucking fun. Like,
the Past was my favorite Zelda game.
It wasn't, or was?
Second favorite Zelda game.
God. Putting it into like an actual title of my favorite's one of the hard decisions, because it's like I've played all of them. Even the bad ones. Even the really, really bad ones.
My friend wants to play Four Sword Randomizer.
Oh, that looks... That sounds fun, but I don't know how that works.
I don't know. I've never played Four Swords.
You've never played Four Swords?
I don't think so. Is that the one with four mini-links?
Yes, so... okay, so here's the basic plot of Zelda Four Swords. Link, Zelda, and the Seven Maidens from Link to the Past. Okay, or I don't think they're the actual maidens from that game, but you get the point. They all go to you played Minish Cap, right?
I know of Minish Cap.
Okay, so the main villain of that game is named Vaadi.
Yeah.
So basically, you go to where they have the Picori sword put at the end of the game. And you go and pick it up. It's now called the Four Sword. And when you do that, you release Vaadi into the world again. And are split into four separate beings. Red, blue, green, and purple. And each person has control of those characters. Or you can play it single player and they all just stay in a line. And you can choose the direction of the line. So if you were a lonely kid like me, that was perfect. But like, that was definitely like one of my first introductions to that type of, cause it's like a Metroidvania almost, but not really.
Yeah.
Cause like, the part that sucks about that game is the talk button, the talk button and the use item button are the exact same button. So sometimes you'll have like the fire rod and you'll just burn down everybody in front of you and accidentally lose like all of your fucking money because of it.
That's a big oof.
Or like roll and pick up are the same button as well. So sometimes you'll just be rolling and you'll pick up your friend and just fucking toss him over a ravine by accident.
Sorry, I didn't mean to.
And at the end of each stage, the way that they rank you is, so you collect these things called Force Gems, which help power you up later throughout the level. And anybody who's listening to this without knowing what the fuck this game is will think I'm on crack by me talking. But, you collect Force Gems and they power you up. And then at the end, you decide who is the biggest burden to the team, and you vote them, and they lose Force Gems for that. And then you choose who is the biggest help to the team, and they gain Force Gems for that. And whoever's got the highest wins.
Oh.
so you don't want to fuck over your teammates too much, or they might call you a hindrance. But if you don't fuck over them enough, you're not going to get enough force shifts. You got to find a healthy balance.
Alrighty then.
It's a bitch, bro. Like, I can't wait to introduce you to some of these randomizers. Because you seem to be enjoying Pokemon a lot.
Well, it's fun because you can get any Pokemon right off the base game.
Yeah. I mean, it's because, like, sometimes you end up with an Articuno.
Yeah, Articuno starter Pokemon.
And
the only issue is with that is now you can't catch anything near you.
Executor.
Dude, the game's like, alright, if you have fucking Zapdos, you have Thunder Wave and Drill Peck, and you're like, every one of these moves is gonna kill him. I can't catch any Pokemon.
That's why Soul Links are so difficult.
That's why I like those types of difficulty things. Like the Dark Souls games. I love the difficultness of the Dark Souls game.
I played all of the first one, played halfway through the second one, and I then just kind of...
Are you talking about Dark Souls?
Yeah, and it just kind of... I kind of fell off
three
the series.
3 got way too easy.
I don't know. It just kind of felt this... It's like shooters. It all becomes the same after a while. Like, it just starts feeling kind of like... This is basically... It's a Dark Souls game. I get it. It didn't have that long-lasting appeal that I was hoping for.
Yeah.
Steven played all of them.
All of the games?
Yep. He's beaten all three. And Bloodborne, I think.
Bloodborne's my favorite Souls game.
I still haven't seen the ending to that game, because that was one of those things where it's like, okay, I played 1 and 2, just fell off it.
The Bloodborne isn't with that game.
Yeah, I know it's not a direct Souls, but it was kind of... Yeah, I linked the two together because they're very similar. Although, I wish I could play the Demon Souls fucking remake.
It's so good.
That game looks fun.
It's so much fun. I bought it for my dad for his birthday last year.
It was fucking broken when it originally came out on PS3. Was it on PS3 or PS2? I don't even fucking remember.
I don't know. It's an older game, though.
But, like...
It was the first Souls-like game.
It was fucking broken. I was impressed the developer stayed alive after that game's release, to be honest. Because, like, it was
a good game. Everyone loved it.
It was unplayable, though.
No.
It was a broken mess.
If you couldn't do it, it was unplayable. That's how they announced it. Like, if you can't do it, don't play it.
Well, no. It was just a literal, like, glitchy fucking mess. Like, I still remember to this day falling through the floor multiple times playing the original, playing it on PS3. I think that's also... I think I would be an excellent bug catcher for video games, like a tester.
Yeah.
Because I know how to break video games very easily.
Oh, I like trying to do... I hate glitching in, like, speedruns and stuff. I don't think it's fair.
I mean, that's why they make glitchless categories, though. Yeah, even then, though, I still see why glitches are fun. Because it literally is just... Do the game as fast as you possibly can. It's finding that absolute limit, you know?
I get it, but, like, you can't do it legitimately fast.
I mean, I'd look at Metroid for that, then, because that's exactly what Metroid created. I mean, there was Mach Ball, there was Shine Smirking. All those were speedrunning tactics for people to use to be able to progressively get to the game through faster. And, I mean, when Mach Ball was first figured out, that was a game changer. Because that allowed you to skip entire fucking areas. Like, because it allowed you to get super missiles early, which allowed you to fight crate early. So, like, you could skip all of, not Fantoon, what's the name? Sproutspore, I think his name is. I can't remember. So you skipped an entire boss. And then if you look at the original Metroid, fucking, you didn't, if you got lucky enough, you only had to fight Kray. I don't think you even had to fight Ridley, because you could just skip over it and get directly to Mother Brain. Like, if you're really mad about the glitch section of speedrunning, that's the game that you want to point to, because it's the one that started it.
I obviously like...
You like long-form gameplay, is what you're saying.
I like, pushing the limits without bending the rules, I guess.
I wouldn't say it's bending the rules. I mean, you can do those things in the game. They're programmed in that way.
But they weren't ever meant to be that way.
Right, but obviously code's meant to be broken, and things are meant to be figured out as time goes on. It is a part of the game. Like, Mach Ball was coded into the game by accident, but it was still coded in. That's my only defense for it, is like... If you can technically do it within the limitations of the game and not running it through, like, a system to do it, I think it should be legal.
Legal.
Well, I say that in terms of, like, fair use in speedrun.
I think it's funny. But
you get what I mean. I don't know. Well, it's, I mean, have you seen Wind Waker speedruns at all?
Yeah. I remember the bomb... through the invisible wall.
Yeah, I mean, that's getting through the, well, nowadays, no, you can literally just fucking... I think you use the grappling hook to get through, because in the HD version, you can walk around with the grappling hook, and that, for some reason, walking backwards with that allows you to super speed yourself up for some reason. I still don't know how. But I mean, that was something they coded in. They just forgot to add a speed limiter. At Mario 64 is to blame with that, too.
Yeah, but then, like, but there was an invisible wall to stop people.
I mean, like I said, I get what you're saying with, like, seeing it legitimately done as fast as possible. But there is something to be said about these people who perform these, like, frame-perfect glitches in such a...
Good for you, it's just not my...
Right. I'm just bringing up the other point of view as well, playing devil's advocate here, to be honest with you.
Yeah.
But it's like, being able to perform a frame-perfect glitch to be able to get yourself, you know, to something else or something like that, that's still an impressive feat.
Yeah.
Because it takes a lot of time to learn those glitches, or learning how to get yourself in a soft lock and then out of a soft lock. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like... There's definitely the appeal to it that I can see on both ends. And it's why both categories exist.
Very true.
I think the game that I definitely want to learn the glitch speedrun for is Mario 64. Just because that looks like so broken.
What star glitch?
Probably 16 star. Just because that's a easy 15-minute run that I can just crank out if I need to. 70 star would probably be next in that order.
70 glitch?
70 star glitched is, I think, the name of the thing, because there's Lakitu skip, there's cutting into the cage at... Like, there's so much of that speedrun. Because 70 star is the legit amount that you need to be able to... you know, get into the Bowser doors and beat the game. But with 16 star, you have to learn the BLJ, and that I'm not ready for, because you have to successfully pull it off twice in a row. Put this down here yesterday.
BLJ.
Backwards long jump.
Is that difficult?
It's okay, so it's all about timing, essentially. So the way it works is, like, you start off with a long jump, but you're having it go back, like you're pulling back on the stick so it's going backwards. And essentially, you mash the button at the right timing to be able, like, it's almost like to the same beat as Eye of the Tiger, almost, except faster, I think. I can't remember how to explain this. But essentially, what it does is each jump that you do while you're going backwards in that long jump, it keeps speeding up Mario. So his speed limiter is set to where, like, essentially he can go from zero speed to a high amount of speed very quickly. And when you're doing that, you're just accelerating him at like a faster pace, and it sends him shooting backwards through the star doors. And then when you get to Bowser, it's easier to do that because it's just an infinite staircase. Because then
Yeah.
you can just mash through it and make yourself fly up there. Yeah, the problem with that is that you can shoot yourself into a painting if you're unlucky. I've seen videos
Through a wall into a panic.
it. Yeah. Like, it's rough, man. But, like, overall, I mean, the run looks super fun, and I would love to at least get, like, a sub 15 or something, but I doubt it. Like, highly doubt it. That game is definitely harder to do.
Yeah.
But I mean,
Oof.
Ocarina is definitely another fun one to learn the full speedrun route for, because you can beat that game in 5 minutes.
Yeah, but you like randomizers for that game.
I love randomizers. They're so fun.
I don't know what the new rules and stuff are.
I haven't. I'm a part of the community. I've got them on Discord, but I haven't checked it in so long because I don't know. Racing hasn't been like the top of my mind.
Yeah, I wonder what new stuff has been added.
I mean, probably a lot to the rule set. I know that basically you skip all of the guards in Zelda's castle, so the sneaking portion's just completely gone.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
They just took it out?
They just completely took it out. It's no longer even a part of that section.
I mean, I guess it's.
Because I mean, it's just a waste of time. You're just gonna be standing around. You know, they want the whole point of that was to make it as fast as possible. But I still know my routing for it.
Yeah.
Yeah, I still have like most of the routing figured out in my head and what each item means. Like I played through one earlier and like I'm talking immediately. It gave me both the blue scale and the gold scale. So I'm like, okay, so it wants me to go diving over at the house. Gotcha. And then it gave me like the boomerang. So I'm like, fuck me, it's wanting Jabus.
Yeah, that's a really annoying area.
Fucking Jabu's belly. I hate that section of the game.
You've hated it. Speedrun ran and randomizer.
I
Or
hate the.
speedrun randomizer in and then in general.
I hated that fucking map to begin with. I mean, it's a stupid dungeon. The layout doesn't make any fucking sense for a fish's guts.
I think you're looking too far into it.
I know, but it was one of those dungeons where I loved all of Ocarina of Time, obviously. I think it's overrated nowadays, but I looking back, I'm like, man, this was just poor dungeon design through and through. Because like there's so many connecting paths and areas where you can like anywhere where a small mistake cost me minutes of my life and of inconvenience, like a single small mistake, I'm not a huge fan of game design wise. I think it just
Is that why rage games aren't your biggest
it
thing?
exactly. Because like if I have to lose minutes of my life from small mistakes that I've made, it just instantly puts me in a bad mood.
So do you like roguelikes then? So every time you die, you have to restart?
It depends. Children of Morta, that was a fun one for me. I haven't played Hades yet, but I've seen some gameplay and it looks cool.
Dude, I can't wait. That's definitely a stream game though, I think.
Yeah.
I love Hades, man.
I mean, there's definitely a lot of those types of games where I'm like, yeah, this is fun, but definitely not every day. Like, I don't think we'll be doing a Let's Play of Hades. I think stream is definitely the best option there.
We could probably do like one or two episodes of it, like to show it off.
Maybe. Maybe, but, yeah. Dude. But like, that shit gets so frustrating after a while, and it's why I just can't. Because I've got such a big fucking vein in my head that starts popping out after the second death, and I'm like, I can't, man. It just doesn't make sense to me on a game design standpoint of, like, why one tiny, tiny mistake should cost you the whole thing. I can understand the appeal to it to some gamers because it's a challenge, but that doesn't even feel like a challenge to me, to be honest. It feels kind of like a good example. Wall Masters and Floor Masters from Zelda. Being sent to the beginning of a dungeon because I got caught once, it was bullshit. I honestly hated that shit. And it's why I fucking hate them to this day, because they're fucking stupid. Fuck Wall Masters.
Did you have one that you hate more?
Version of the Wall Master?
Like Wall versus Floor?
I mean, they're essentially the same.
I know, but like, which one's more annoying?
Probably Floor Masters, just because they're there. Well, it's like, it's Wall Masters go from come from the ceiling, and Floor Masters go from wall to wall. So, I mean, honestly, probably Wall Masters, actually, because not being able to see the enemy, and it just popping out of nowhere, and that's it. You're sent back to the beginning of the dungeon. Done. That just seems. It seems like padding to make the game seem longer, you know?
Yeah.
Because, you know, sometimes you'll get caught in those traps 2, 3, maybe even 4 times in a row. It's just frustrating, dude. It's why I hope to God, if they do anything, they don't add them to Breath of the Wild 2.
Did they add them in the regular?
No.
Breath of the Wild?
I don't think so. I would have remembered that. I don't think they're in any of the Breath of the Wild. The first one, I mean. But if they add them to 2, I think, honestly, it's probably going to ruin my experience with that game. Because being sent back to the beginning of a dungeon in that game is fucking so much time killed.
Breath of the Wild didn't even really have dungeons.
I mean, but even the beasts. Even the beasts. Being sent to the beginning of those is fucking brutal. Any death in that game that sent you back was brutal, but being sent back just by a regular enemy, that would fucking kill my experience with that game. And I like I said, I still think it's one of the best Zelda games, period.
It's not a Zelda game, though.
It is! I mean, it's the ultimate Zelda game. It literally goes back to its roots, and that's why I loved it. Because Zelda was about, you know, adventuring, finding, you know, those little points of interest and going off and doing whatever the hell you wanted and maybe find a cave or two along the way. Maybe meet some fun people. That's what Zelda was, because, I mean, I guess I grew up playing the original on the Wii, which don't do that. That's a horrible thing to do to yourself.
Yeah, it didn't age well, did it?
No, not the Wii. The Wii didn't. The Switch is definitely a vastly better system.
Yeah.
For its time, though, it was revolutionary.
Yeah.
I mean, being able to...
Wii bowling.
Oh, God, yeah, that was revolutionary on its own. Was being able to just have full control over the ball.
Yeah.
But, I mean, yeah, I mean... Overall, it's just video games as a whole. They've gotten better, but I also think they've gotten worse, you know?
Yeah.
It feels like...
But then again, you don't like a lot of the newer stuff because you're not into it.
Well, I mean, it just feels like designers are getting lazier and lazier with choices, you know?
Yeah.
Like... Things are becoming very much like... I don't know how to put it. It's not inspired, because that's not the good word I want to use here, because it's just becoming the same. Every time I play a new game, it's why I'm enjoying Dragon Quest so much, is because it's something so vastly different to what I'm used to seeing.
Yeah.
And it's a new game. But it's like, here's a good example, okay? The last 3-4 Call of Duty games that have come out have all been pretty much the exact same fucking thing. I mean, I know that's a controversial standpoint because there's different guns and different things like that.
I know what you mean, though.
But it has very much been the same game for 3 or 4 of games of the series. That goes for fucking the older Zeldas before Breath of the Wild, when it came down to it, because Skyward Sword was basically just the same thing as, like, Twilight Princess, but way worse! Way worse! Huh.
What are you talking about? Skyward Sword's the best Zelda game.
I hate you. No, worst. Worst game on the planet. And I had to I've beaten that game like 7 or 8 times. I could speedrun that fucking game if I wanted to. I know how to fight every enemy.
Best Zelda game. Especially the flying mechanic.
God, no! They made that shit so slow for no reason.
Their use of the stamina bar, in my opinion, was great.
Leave. Get out. No more.
It was perfect timing. It didn't need to be any longer than it needed.
No, it just didn't need to fucking exist to begin with. Because all it did was just pad the game to be fucking longer. If the stamina bar didn't exist and I could just run it with however the fuck I wanted to, that game would have been 10 times better. But no, they added a fucking stamina bar. Because they needed a way to make the fucking game last any amount longer. Because they realized, oh shit, we just made a game where we repeat the same fucking 3 areas 3 times in a fucking row!
I hate to say it, but I think they copied Super Mario Galaxy. Copied that for a while. With all the flying to different planets.
What are you talking about?
Fucking, don't you fly on the bird to different islands?
Yes, but those are galaxies. These are literal land masses.
The reason I said it is because I think Galaxy came out first.
Yeah, Galaxy did come out first. I think it came out because it came out for the 25th anniversary of Zelda. Because I have the, like...
Because fucking Galaxy came out on the Wii. But so did...
But Skyward Sword had the Wii Motion Plus, which didn't come out for a little while. It was required that you had it. So I had Ma buy me the one with it built in. And that.
I remember that damn sensor bar you had to sit on the top of your fucking TV. And if you had a flat screen TV, you had to balance that fucking shit. God.
Yeah, that's what was good about the Wii Motion Plus, though, is that you didn't need it any longer. It just read your movements.
Well, yeah, because if you put the scanning bar at the very bottom, it barely picked up anything because I was way too fucking tall.
Right. I think that's why the Switch is probably the better system to play it on, if you're gonna, which I don't suggest. That game sucks. Although they added fucking button controls, which they said back when that game released that they didn't think that game could be done without button control, with button controls. And then, lo and behold, 2021 rolls around, and what do they fucking make? Skyward Sword with fucking button controls. I can't. Like that series, I don't understand Nintendo's decisions sometimes, because it's like, you said back then that this was not a fucking possibility.
Skyward Sword, best Zelda game.
No, if anything, it's probably one of the 2Ds. And my votes.
Link to the Past.
Link to the Past, A Link's Awakening. I've maybe the oracles, to be honest, but I don't think you've even touched those.
No, I haven't. Kyle, everybody knows that Majora's Mask is the best fundamental Zelda game.
I mean, but it's not a Zelda game.
What are you talking about? Majora's Mask laid down the founding bricks of Zelda.
No. Yeah, I will say it's probably one of my favorites because it's not a Zelda game. Of the 3D ones.
They had no idea what they were doing for that game.
But that was the thing. That was fine. Because it came out, like, God, I think 9 months after Ocarina did.
Yeah, but it's so, like, they were like, we're just gonna throw it out.
Right, but I mean, it worked conceptually. The game was supposed to be a darker version of Ocarina, which Ocarina itself, as a kid, was already pretty fucking dark.
Yeah.
I mean, so they essentially made a darker version of the game that felt that dealt more with, you know, death, understanding, corruption, if that makes sense, and like corruption of worlds, not corruption of governments, yeah. But like. It was
Can
such
get a government corruption simulator, please.
Oh God, I'm trying to remember the name of the game, but there was a game where you could run as a politician. But anyway, it was so vastly different that it stood out amongst the rest of them. Like, yeah, Twilight Princess was good in its own merit, but it was so overly long for no reason.
Yeah.
And I mean, Wind Waker is Wind Waker. It's always gonna be that classic, you know?
Still plenty of flaws in it, though.
But, you know, when it came down to it,
oh, yeah, it was great.
Majora's Mask had all these vastly, like, these very intricate side quests, and it had the time mechanic to it, which I know a lot of people were annoyed by, but it was easy to get around. You could slow down the time to and speed it up how you wanted to. It was so unique in its time. But nowadays, I feel like they could not do it. Yeah. But I think that's where we're going to call it for today.
Alright.
Yeah, we've got about an hour.
That was a good episode.
Any last thoughts?
Not off my head. What about you?
Mostly just think about the game design today. Maybe push for a little bit better game design, but that's it.
I have something to talk to you about after though.
That's fine. Alright. But we'll go ahead and see you guys on the next episode of the JK Podcast. Thank you all for coming out. If you like this, go ahead and share this around and subscribe. Later.